get a chance.
Hi, guys.
Hi. Hello, everyone.
Hi.
So, Router essentially is about connecting sports fans online and offline and making them enjoy the prediction game during the live matches. Sports industry traditionally is about fantasy leagues, which is not about live matches. And the social media interaction is limited to the traditional social media. There is no social media platform which allows people to connect one-on-one. What Router, you know, tries to do is to fill that gap in the life of a fan. My name is Piyush. I head the business for Router. He's Soham. Hi. He heads the product for Router. And together for the last 10 months, we have been in this journey. We have built Router. As a part of our seed round, we have raised 40 lakhs from at the valuation of 10 crore from Bollywood actor Boman Irani, who is also a huge sports fan. We are looking at raising 1.5 crores here at the same valuation.
I have a problem. I hate loneliness. I hate being alone. And then one fine day, this young man called Piyush meets me, and he pitches the motherload of like-minded sports people, and the motherload of quizzing with like-minded sports people, and the motherload of fighting and arguing and having conflict with like-minded sports people. And he said, I have an app called Router, where you can meet all your like-minded friends, find people who like a particular sport or a particular team or a particular event, sit and discuss it, argue about it, make predictions about it. There's a game involved, there are quizzes involved, and when you have people together doing this together, I think it's a wonderful, wonderful place to be.
Where is the business model? Where is the revenue coming from? Is it coming or is it not coming?
We have three revenue models currently in our mind. Advertisement is one, second is the lead generation, third is the sponsorship. We are open to sponsorship by different sports brands.
Guys, those are all form of advertising. What you just said, is there anything else besides advertising that you have in mind?
So we have one more model which we want to build in future, which will essentially be the freemium model. What we will have is that we'll have two layers of engagement on the app. One will be something which is free, where you come, connect with people, play live match. The other would be that we charge a very nominal amount for them to get into the game, to get brand gifts, to maybe get discounts from the F&B outlets, to maybe get discounts from the nearest store. And at the
same
time,
have you thought of betting?
See, in terms of betting, it's very differentiated in India. It's game of skill versus game of chance. So if there is a game of skill, the fantasy leagues in India is running and it's running.
No, but couldn't you put skill through the prediction part of it and try to get people
There is skill involved in it, but what we want to do initially is that we want to experiment with gifts as well as betting. So initially the approach that we want to take is like an in-app purchase kind of thing.
So why will I connect? Say for example, if I'm based out of Delhi, I already have my friends, so I'm going to go out. A lot of sports bars around where me and my friends will go and we'll meet people who are actually watching, say, Man U match over there, and we will bond. For example, if I go to Surat or say Mumbai, over there I don't have my friends, then probably I'll use Routers once. Yeah. And then I'll make them my friends. They'll be on my WhatsApp, they'll be on my contacts, so I would not need them again. Is it only if I'm going to a newer city where I don't know anyone, then only if I'll be using this, then the market is too small. And the gaming, if you're only concentrating on gaming, then I would love to bet on this.
You get users with whatever advertising, monetizing them is going to be tough. I feel that there is a significant opportunity, if this game really works, of licensing it B2B to all the sports teams in the world. Right? You license this to Mumbai Indians,
sure.
You co-brand it together, then you can get 2 million, 10 million downloads. Right?
See,
then monetizing is easier.
Are you allowed to do a down round?
As in come down on the valuation?
Yes.
No, we don't want to come down.
No, why would you say you don't want to come down? At least listen to somebody's offer.
Exactly. You made up your mind, that's okay.
Right?
See, but then why you here?
Sure.
Come on. Get an offer. Right? Offer, have an attitude of gratitude there, right?
It's better to say no to something you have than not have it at all.
Sure.
I would give you an offer of 50 lakh rupees for 25%.
Wow.
So that's
50 lakh rupees.
50 lakh rupees. 25%.
That's 2 crore value. This is a heavily technology led play. You don't have a co-founder as a CTO. That worries me a lot. And usually that's not a good thing if you're going to be technology led. The other thing is the freemium model I don't think will work if I just look at conversion rates of other businesses who are trying to do similar stuff that you are. And for all these reasons, I'm going to pass.
Honestly, I think I agree with him. The value, I think, is completely off the charts. I don't think I can give you anything close to it. So I'm going to pass.
You've got Mr. Boman. I have highest of respect for that man. Amazing job he's done in Bollywood. I'm going to give you an offer of 30 lakhs at 10%. So that value your company at 3 crores, not 10.
Wow, your valuation just jumped 50% from 2 crores to 3 crores. Well done. Maybe if you go all the way down, it'll jump up 50% again.
It's very shaky for me. Within 10 days, the valuation changes. I would rather play on a day trade on the stock exchange. I don't like this kind of investment. I want to stay out.
Betting is a huge market. If you guys are into betting, I would have been interested because that's a market where I'm interested. You're not there. As and when you are there, I'll be interested. But at this stage, kind of valuation you're suggesting without any revenue assurance, I think I will be not interested in investing at this stage. So far, pass for me as well.
See, just to sum it up, I think thank you so much for the offer. We believe that somebody else is trying to value add at a certain and they believe that we can reach over there. If I agree or if we agree to anything which is below that, it would be almost saying that they made a mistake. And that is something that first we don't feel and that is something that we don't want them to feel. Thank you for your offer. Thank you for your time. Thank you for your feedback. Unfortunately, we'll not be able to take it because we need to back our investors right now and we need to back ourselves to believe this particular platform. Thank you so much for your time and we'll see you soon again. Keep rooting for us though. Keep rooting for us. Thank you.
There were a couple of deals which were offered, but it weren't offered on the valuation that we were looking for. So we didn't take the deal.
It's not about money, right? So what happens is, if they want to connect sports fans, whatever you do, you can't root them into a different direction of betting, right? It is money making, but this is what the passion is, that they want to connect sports fans, they chat with each other. But you know what, the money is there because, you know, all the sponsors...
Like, but everybody thought of that about Facebook, that there's no money Snapchat, there. Yeah. You know, they've created a money out of connecting people.
I know, but
what are you saying? It's connecting people, yeah? No. So I think the thing is...
Business works on billions of user scale.
Absolutely. Yeah,
advertising
this can't.
Is
there a company globally? Something of this
there's
sort?
There's nobody.
Lots of betting companies.
Betting,
lot of,
yes.
Yeah, there are fan platforms.
Yeah,
yeah.
Fan platforms.
Iran, all no, but there's a couple of large fan platforms.
But that's all offline or online?
All of them have their own fan platforms.
Online fan.
Very large.
All of them have their own.